Hello, everyone. Welcome to the multi-tenant administration session for Service Health and Message Center. I'm Gobinder Saini, and I'm a PM on the M365 Admin Center team. I'm responsible for building Service Health and Message Center experiences that bring to you service communications. Today, I'm going to talk about the experiences we are building for admins who manage multiple tenants, who I will be referring to as multi-tenant admins for the rest of the session. I will talk about why are we investing in multi-tenant administration and why service communication experiences. I will also demonstrate our brand spanking new multi-tenant administration experience for Service Health, and also talk about our ideas on building similar experience for Message Center where you can manage your change notifications. Okay, so let's start with multi-tenant administration and service communications. What does it really mean for you? First question I'm going to try and answer is why multi-tenant management? So if you are a frequent user of Service Health and Message Center in Microsoft 365 Admin Center, you are accustomed to consuming and actioning on our Service Health communications in the context of a single tenant. In our research and data analysis, we identified that almost one third of the tenants administered using Microsoft 365 Admin Center are actually managed by admins who administer multiple tenants. So who are these tenants or who are these admins? These are the admins technicians of Microsoft partners who sell services on behalf of Microsoft and who are essentially cloud solution providers, also known as CSPs, or managed service providers, MSPs. They basically manage tenants on behalf of their customers, and hence they are always requiring the need to manage multiple tenants at the same time. These are also admins of organizations who have multiple tenants. And the reason they have multiple tenants is because it could be a result of a merger or an acquisition. It's because the company maintains multiple tenants to support their testing environments, for example, dev, test, pre-production. Or it could be because the organization has to maintain separate tenants for each of the companies or subsidiaries due to various data regulations. So we dug into all the wonderful feedback that we have gathered from you over various channels and also spoke to many multi-tenant admins about your business needs. And here are some of the key challenges that we learned that are faced by admins day in and day out. Starting with the biggest challenge of logging into or switching between different tenants, since our admin center is designed to support the context of a single tenant. In addition, the lack of aggregated views to monitor and track status of services across tenants forces them in a reactive mode rather than a proactive mode. And also, not able to take any actions across managed tenants are some of the major issues impacting them. So let's talk about how are we going about addressing these issues, since our goal is to provide a unified experience across tenants without having to juggle between them. Earlier this year, my colleagues in the M365 Admin Center brought to you the ability to switch tenants via tenant picker in the Admin Center. So if you're a partner, you don't have to go back to the partner center to log back into another client tenant anymore. And we have got rave reviews on how helpful this is, and I'm super glad that this has been beneficial, which is great. However, you're still working in the context of a single tenant, which is still a challenge. So the same team who brought you the tenant switcher is now building on that feature set and bringing to you the ability to view and manage multiple tenants at the same time. So no need to open multiple sessions of Admin Center in separate browsers or in private mode. The all tenants view provides a snapshot of insights for Service Health, support requests, products billing information, licensing, number of active users, and your role on the tenant. And this is across all the tenants that you manage. This view is being rolled out as we speak, so be on the lookout. I also encourage you to learn more about the overall multi-tenant management roadmap in my colleague Tim's session titled Multi-Tenant Management in Microsoft 365 Admin Center. So let's go deeper into service communications. The feedback from the customers has been loud and clear to us that service-related comms are extremely important to multi-tenant admins. This helps them to provide quality support to the end users and also to manage service changes, make sure the users are aware of all the changes that are coming in and the new features that are rolling out. So right on the heels of the all tenants view, we will roll out the ability to view service communications across all your tenants. We have prioritized the shipping of Service Health over Message Center, and this is, again, a direct result of the customer input that we have got. I must add that your feedback and partnership has been instrumental in designing and building this functionality. So before I get to the demo, a quick request. It would be great if you can continue sharing your experiences by responding to a few questions here. As I mentioned, this is super helpful to us as we build out new features and helps us to prioritize as well. We have a microserver link available for you to answer a few questions about your experience, and we also have a customer panel available that you can join. Once you're in this panel, we will invite you to participate in our usability studies and to co-design experiences. And outside of this, please do feel free to reach out to us at the below mentioned email address to provide any feedback or ask any questions regarding Service Health or the Message Center experiences. As I mentioned earlier, we will be bringing aggregated Service Health views first, which is targeted to improve the quality of support that you offer to your users. One of our main goals is to help you become proactive in servicing your customers by drawing actionable insights across your tenants instead of being reactive and relying on notifications. So let's get into the demo to learn more about this experience. Let's start the demo with the admin center. If you're an admin who manages multiple tenants, when you log into M365 Admin Center, you will now be greeted with a tenant switcher. The tenant switcher helps you to log into the context of any of your managed tenants or switch context from one tenant to another without having to manually sign in and sign out. What's new here is the option to log into the context of all tenants by clicking on either the View Insights across all your tenants, which is at the bottom of your page of the tenant switcher, or you can log into the All Tenants by clicking on the All Tenants link here on the top of the left-hand navigation bar. This helps you land on the All Tenants view. So let's go ahead and click on it. Okay. Loading the Service Health. All right, there it is. Okay, so the All Tenants view gives you a glimpse of all your managed tenants and gets a quick view into your Service Health, support requests, products, and billing status. This is what I call your start your day view to understand what's going on with your tenants. You can expand the rows to get additional details, or you can collapse them to view what's happening across all your tenants. One of the most important things to highlight here is that if you have a high number of tenants, you can mark some of them as your favorites. This is extremely beneficial to admins who want to float their production tenants at the top, because you may not be very keen to understand what's happening with respect to your test tenants, so you float your test production tenants at the top, or for tenants that you work more often with. So now let's go ahead and understand, once you've got a fair understanding of what's happening for each of your tenants, how do you go ahead and support your customers and your end users? So for that, we'll click on the Service Health. All right, so at your very first glance, you are now informed of any issues affecting your tenants. The insights at the top of the page draw attention to the number of incidents and the advisories affecting any of your tenants. In addition, it also communicates the services affected by all the incidents. And without any additional navigation, you have a comprehensive view of all the services along with the details of the incidents and the advisories affecting them. You could also collapse all the services and see which other services are impacted. You get to see all the healthy services. And this is a list of all the services that are subscribed or activated by your tenants. When you look at this data, there's one important question that is getting answered. In addition to just knowing what incidents or advisories are impacting your services, it's also telling you how many of your tenants are impacted. It does it at the service level, and it also does it at the individual issue level. So let me expand this so you can have a clear view of what those issues are. So you can see the title of the issues here, along with the status, number of tenants affected, the ID of the incident, and the start time and the last updated time. So you have all the information, summary information, or the metadata information associated with the issue displayed here. Okay, so as an admin, when you're responding to a user complaint or you're proactively monitoring the issues, your next logical step is to understand the gravity of the issues and to learn about the latest updates, which is done by clicking on the incident. So let's go ahead and click on the incident. The right panel provides those important set of details under the overview tab for you to take necessary actions as appropriate. For example, you either want to inform your customers or you want to share workaround, etc., etc. One important thing, unlike your single tenant experience, you can now click on the tenants affected tab to view the list of all the tenants affected by the particular incident and the respective status for each tenant. Yes, the incident status is not available on the main all services or all issues list, unlike the single tenant experience, since the status could be different for different tenants. For example, some of your tenants could be in a service interruption state wherein they're not able to do anything with the service, while some tenants could be in the service degradation state wherein the service is slow or the issue is intermittent. You can use the filter options to view the list by a specific status. In this case, all the tenants have the same status. So if I click on it, it filters to the same list. So I'm going to clear the filter here. There you go. One more thing to talk about. I referred to the favorites on the All Tenants page. Note that all the tenants that you marked as favorites on the All Tenants page are showing up at the top. So this is super helpful if you are trying to focus on certain customers or certain tenants. One of the other key asks from the customers was the ability to inform your users or customers from here. And many admins shared that they use different modalities like Teams, Yammer, or third-party tools to communicate to their end users. So what we have done is we have incorporated the ability to export the list of the affected tenants into a CSV, such that you can share it with your support teams and they can in turn service their end users. So let's go ahead and open this file. And you can see, you can see the list of your tenants. You can see which ones are favorites. You can see their status and you can see the default domain. Put two of them open. All right, there's one other view that flatly lists out all the issues, and that's the all issues view. Now on this view, you can filter based on the issue type. So if you want to focus only on the incidents, then you can filter it based on the incidents or the advisories. Or if you want to focus on only one service, then you can do that as well. For example, Yammer. So now apparently there is no issue with incident with Yammer, which is a good thing. All right. So this comes in handy for admins or support teams who are focusing on a specific workload. And even from this list, you can still get to more details and the list of affected tenants by just clicking on the incident. So which comes in handy. So what have we done? We have attempted to flip the focus of your support experience from a reactive to a proactive one. You can now use this dashboard to identify all the tenants that are impacted and inform them accordingly. If you do not see your issue here, you can still navigate into the context of a single tenant and report an issue on their behalf. For example, you can go back to All Tenants view, click on a specific tenant in whose context you want to get into. So in this case, I'm going to click into Conto CSP only. And then if you're not seeing any issue that's impacting your users for this tenant, you can come in and report an issue on their behalf. Now you may ask, why not have reporting an issue on behalf of multiple tenants or share the tenant list from the ServiceL dashboard itself via an email or some other modality or set up notifications across all your tenants? Now this is exactly why we want to hear from you. Tell us what other functionality or insights should we build and prioritize to ensure we help you be more productive and successful at supporting your customers with ServiceL communications. All right. So far, so good. But what about change management communications? Here's the good news. I'm happy to share that we are working on a multi-tenant management view of Message Center. And the idea here is the same. That is to provide a glimpse into all the important change communications and the respective tenants that they apply to. The guiding principle for us is to ensure you don't have to log into each tenant individually. And instead, we want to build efficiency in your daily processes by enabling actions across tenants. Having said that, our work is not done. We have made major strides in enabling you to switch between tenants and to get access to across all your tenants through aggregated views. However, we still have work to do on doing repetitive actions across tenants and spotting and synchronizing differences between them. Some of the future releases that we are working on the service communication side of things are building the multi-tenant administration scenarios for Message Center, building the incident history for all your tenants, and then giving you the ability to perform bulk actions across tenants in the service health, for example, subscribing to notifications, reporting an issue on behalf of your customer, or sharing incident details. So we look forward to your feedback, and we hope you will be able to take the survey or will be able to join our customer panel to share your experiences. We are super excited to bring these experiences to you, and we are hoping you are just as excited. On that note, thank you very much for attending this session and have a great, great day.